Trump poses for pic with boy at Arlington and everyone immediately noticed one shocking thing in it. President Donald Trump's first Memorial Day as president proved the vast difference between him and his predecessor. The brave men and women who fought and died for this country were finally honored by our leadership in a way they deserve, as Trump exuded pride and appreciation for our military and country that's been absent from Washington, D.C. for 8 years. As the ceremonies wound down and Trump spent some time at Arlington Cemetery, he was caught in a picture with a little boy. Being one of the most approachable presidents in history, Trump didn't shy away from the endearing moment caught of him talking to this child like he was his own. However, as soon as the Memorial Day snapshot hit the internet, everyone immediately noticed one shocking thing in it on closer look. Trump's time at Arlington Cemetery yesterday for the Memorial Day ceremony was well documented by the liberal media, who negatively focused on the fact that he sang along with the national anthem. While they were consumed in hate and criticism for our patriotic president, Trump was more concerned with this specific little boy rather than paying attention to the opinions of irrelevant people. The reason for his attention was captured in this powerful photo, and we now know why it didn't get the airtime occupied by other things. Among those who joined the president for the ceremony yesterday were families of fallen American heroes. Trump didn't just make an appearance and send a general wave out to everyone there that day. He spent one-on-one time with many of them, including several children, one of which was a 6-year-old who was dressed in a Marine uniform and lost his father in 2011 while serving our country. Another child who received individual attention was a boy who is reportedly the son of another important hero. According to a relative of the boy's family who contacted Freedom Daily, the boy pictured above is the son of a current police officer and Trump supporter. The boy had the opportunity to attend the Memorial Day ceremony at the cemetery this week and was delivered a special message from our president. He was allegedly told by the commander-in-chief himself that his father would be so proud of you, Trump said, according to a Twitter post by @HowardMortman. He stood beside him with his arm around the boy as if he was his own grandson and warmly treated as such as he spoke encouraging words to him. It was a rare and special opportunity that this boy will probably never forget, thanks to the president who took time for everyone. This sincere conversation came after a moving Memorial Day address Trump had just given to the nation in front of these special families who got to hear it and feel it in person. NBC4 reports, President Donald Trump expressed his nation's boundless and undying gratitude Monday to Americans who have fallen in battle and to the families they left behind, hailing as heroes the hundreds of thousands buried at Arlington National Cemetery. In his first Memorial Day remarks as president, Trump told the stories of two soldiers who died in Afghanistan, Green Beret Captain Andrew D. Byers of Colorado Springs and Christopher D. Horton of the Oklahoma National Guard, as Byers' parents and Horton's widow looked on. Of the men all who died in military service, he said, words cannot measure the depth of their devotion, the purity of their love or the totality of their courage. The last two Memorial Day ceremonies before this one felt like a mockery of our military and for America, since it was delivered by a man who routinely disregarded soldiers and their service. Barack Obama wasn't concerned with fortifying the greatest military in the world. He financially stripped them down to the point where they had to retrieve parts needed to repair military aircraft from a junkyard. This was in addition to his 8-year habit of not saluting soldiers who were saluting him while standing post at Air Force One and Marine One. When a hero would die, Obama wouldn't even address it. However, if a thug was killed in the commission of a crime by a cop, Obama's number one priority immediately became avenging the criminal's death. When terrorists killed soldiers, Obama pulled boots off the ground and gave money to the enemy. Trump responds with hellfire when this happens now. This picture of our president with a boy who lost his dad in war, and another's whose father serves and protects citizens daily as a police officer, shows the difference of priorities in commander-in-chiefs. Trump cares about those who risk their lives for us and their families. Correction note, this article was updated on May 31, 2017. After receiving clarification from an individual claiming to be a relative of the family, that the boy's father is a police officer and not a fallen soldier.
Please do not forget like on videos, and subscribe, and comment because your voice matters, and visit our page on Facebook, and like them, and follow up. And thanks for watching.